Also tonight, we have new information on what led to the kidnapping of a Lubbock woman, the shooting of her son, and her eventual death. KCBD News Channel 11's Natalie Falkenberry joins us in the studio now with what we know about the suspect, the victim, and their brief acquaintance. Natalie.
Karen, right now, Lubbock police are only charging 42-year-old Miguel Garcia with aggravated assault with a deadly weapon. They say he shot and wounded a man in Northeast Lubbock Tuesday night, then kidnapped his mother. Terry County deputies found 58-year-old Stacy Williams' body the next morning. Police say it started here at an apartment complex near 1st and East Tulane. Around 11:30 Tuesday night, investigators rushed to the parking lot where they found 40-year-old Jabbar Smith with a gunshot wound. His mother, 58-year-old Stacy Williams, was missing. Paramedics rushed Smith to the ER where doctors treated him for serious injuries. They expect him to survive. Investigators with LPD say through the initial investigation, they learned that Smith heard a struggle and went outside his apartment to find his mom. He told police he saw Miguel Garcia fighting with Williams, trying to kidnap her. When he tried to stop it, police say Garcia pulled a gun and shot Smith, then left him behind, taking Williams with him. While he was in the hospital, Smith told police Garcia and his mom had met a few months prior. They'd been out for drinks on a couple of occasions, but according to police, they hadn't spoken for 2 months. Smith said Garcia showed up Tuesday night wanting to take Williams out again, but she refused. That's when the fight started. Only 8 hours later, Wednesday morning, deputies in Terry County found a body 6 miles south of Brownfield on Highway 137. Investigators identified it as Williams hours later. The Lubbock SWAT team arrested Garcia yesterday afternoon for aggravated assault with a deadly weapon. He's held on $1 million bond. It's unclear at this point how Williams died, but we do now know multiple outside agencies are helping with this case, including state troopers, the Texas Rangers, the FBI, and ATF. Karen.
Thank you, Natalie.